Georgia jails opposition leader. The Supreme Court sentencing Gigugulava to over 3 years in prison has become the most discussed topic among Georgians on social media. Ugulava, one of the leaders of the opposition European Georgian Party, got 38 months of prison term for embezzling 48 million Georgian laris. In response to this, Georgian opposition front halted talks with the ruling Georgian Dream Party over electoral reforms, also followed by critical statements by US lawmakers, the EU, the UK and a number of other Georgia's Western partners. This is anything but normal. Ivanishvili's court is a total swamp, and this means the country backsliding to the past, opposition Lelo party member Irakli Kupradze wrote on Facebook. The former Georgian Prime Minister Georgi Gurikashvili also weighed in on Facebook, calling Gugulava sentencing an example of political influence on Georgian judiciary. With a step like this, the government will be held responsible for further political polarization in Georgia, Gurikashvili stated. Some welcomed Gurikashvili for speaking up, only to find out later that ex-Prime Minister's page became unavailable on Facebook. This triggered speculation whether pro-government accounts reported his page en masse, an attack tactic that frequently works on Facebook. Whatever the case, this month anti-opposition voices definitely started to flock to Twitter, a platform of Georgian government's foreign critics to counter them directly. A journalist called out for homophobia. Last week on Facebook, Georgian journalist Givi Avaliani challenged his colleague Georgi Targamadze for his homophobia. Targamadze, a TV anchor who has recently also become an associate director of a TV channel Formula, is a former conservative politician. He and his Christian Democratic Movement actively campaigned for a constitutional ban on same-sex marriage in Georgia as early as in 2012. His whole election campaign was based on propagating hate. All this doesn't matter anymore? Avaliani asked, who in his subsequent Facebook update reported that he had received Targamadze's reply on this matter. Targamadze was quoted apologizing to vulnerable groups for his several old statements. Not everyone thought it was enough. He wasn't just a homophobe, he was creating homophobia. I was being attacked at my university while Christian Democratic Movement gathered signatures for a homophobic amendment to the constitution, gay activist Bekagabadadze wrote. Meet mincers for women. A recent decision by Zugdidi City Hall to gift meat mincer machines to successful women met mixed reactions. Tornike Chumburidze, master's student at Central European University, called it an unintentional feminist initiative. Grinding meat in Zugdidi and in a lot of other places is done by women. This is an unfortunate reality. Given these circumstances, meat mincing machines are going to make their lives easier and will gain them more free time, a time also to change that reality, Chumburidze argued. Some strongly disagreed. Exactly what kind of work is it going to make easier? Do you really think that we women living in rural areas actually sit and grind meat all day? Sabunia Vartagava wrote on Facebook. Assistance should be universal. These 20 meat mincers, small grants and etc. are harmful policies that make the state operate as a corporation, pushing its citizens to compete with each other, queer feminist Nugrit Abidze wrote. Lagodekhi Mayor becomes a meme. John Domdimnishvili, a mayor of Lagodekhi town in eastern Kakheti region, never intended to go viral nationwide, not within a day and the way it happened anyway. Users on social media turned him into a meme after his office photoshopped his oversized image on the background of the road construction site that he had failed to actually visit. An awkward photo manipulation set off a wave of creativity among Georgians online.